Hello friends, myself Sandeep Javheri, Assistant Professor Department of Civil Engineering from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In today's session, we are going to discuss the problem on linear motion for horizontal type motion. The learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to solve problem on linear motion. Now, linear motion, in this, the body is in motion in a straight line. It is known as linear motion. For example, a car is moving on the road and a body is projected vertically upward in the air with a certain velocity. Another example is a body is falling vertically downwards. So, if car is moving on a road, so that motion is in a horizontal plane, so that is called horizontal motion. Now body is projected vertically upwards or downwards, so it is a vertical motion. The linear motion may be uniform linear motion with constant velocity or zero acceleration. Since the slope is zero, we have dv by dt is equal to zero, that means acceleration is zero. And non-uniform linear motion with variable velocity or non-zero acceleration. So acceleration is variable here. The third case is uniform acceleration. The linear motion may have the motion in which the body have uniform acceleration. Now let us consider the equations of motion with uniform acceleration. There are three equations of motion. The first one is v is equal to u plus at. Second is s equals to u into t plus half at square. The third equation is v square is equal to u square plus 2as, where s is a displacement, u is the initial velocity, and v is a final velocity, and t is a duration of a body in a particular motion. Now let us consider an example, a problem on horizontal motion with uniform acceleration. Three marks A, B and C are at a distance of 100 meter each, are made along a straight road. A car starting from rest and with uniform acceleration passes the mark A and takes 10 seconds to reach B and further 8 seconds to reach the mark C. Calculate the magnitude of the acceleration of the car, the velocity of the car at A, the velocity of car at B, and the distance of the mark A from the starting point. So here we have to find out the four things. Let us find out the solution for this given problem. Find out the solution of the given problem. Let us consider this is a point O from where the car is started to move along a straight path. So let us consider this is a point A, this is a mark B, this is a mark C. The distance between A to B and B to C is same, that is 100 meter. Since the car is moving from rest at O, the initial velocity here it is 0. Then car passing from A, then A to B, then B to C. Let velocity at A is VA, velocity at B is VB. Here we have to find out the velocity of A and velocity of B. And also we have to find out what is the distance of the car from rest up to the mark A. So let us consider the distance is X. So given the time taken by the car to move from A to B is say t1, which is equals to time taken by car from A to B, which is given as 10 seconds. Let t2 time taken by car from B to C, which is equals to 8 seconds. Let A be the acceleration of car during its motion. So let us consider motion of car from A to B using equation of horizontal motion, that is S equals to ut plus half at square. So here displacement is given as A to B is 100 meter. So 100 equals to initial velocity of car is ua. So this is initial velocity of car, or velocity of car at A is ua, and the time from A to B is 10 seconds plus half of acceleration into time is 10 bracket square. So this is equation number 1. Further we solve this, 100 is equal to 10 ua plus 50 a. This is equation number 1. So this is the equation number 1. Now let us consider motion of car from A to C. Again using equation S equals to ut plus half at square. Here displacement is 200 meter and initial velocity is ua, and time taken is from A to C is 18 seconds plus half into a into 18 square. We are getting 200 is equal to 18 ua plus half into a into 18 square. So by simplifying this, we are getting 200 is equal to 18 ua plus 162A. So this is equation number 2. So solving equation 1 and 2, we get acceleration is equal to 0.278 meter per second square, and velocity of car at A is equal to 8.61 meter per second. Now let us consider motion of car from B to C. So we have from B to C, the distance is 100 meter, velocity is ub. So we have using S equals to ut plus half at square, put the value of S as 100 meter, that is equals to velocity of car is ub and time taken is 8 seconds plus half into the acceleration is 0.278 times t is 8 seconds, so bracket square. So By solving this, velocity of car at B is equal to 11.38 meter per second. So velocity of car at A is equal to 8.61 meter per second, and velocity of car at B is equal to 11.38 meter per second. Acceleration of car is equal to, that is A is equal to 0.278 meter per second square. Now let us consider distance of mark A from starting point O. So consider motion O to A. So we have, this is O, this is A, so this distance is x. So initial velocity of car is 0 because it is starting from rest. So using v square is equal to u square plus 2as, we can find the distance. So here v is nothing but velocity of car at A, which is 8.61 meter per second. So 8.61 square is equal to initial velocity of car is 0 plus 2 times 0.278 times x. So value of x will be 133.33 meter. So we are getting the distance of car from rest, that is from O to A, is 133.33 meter. Just to pause the video and answer this question. So this is a solution. The car is moving with a velocity of 5 meter per second. After 10 seconds, it attains final velocity of 15 meter per second. So acceleration of the car can be obtained by using the expression v minus u divided by t. So final velocity is 15, initial velocity is 5, and time is 10 seconds. So after putting this, we are getting the acceleration of car is equal to 15 minus 5 divided by 10, that is equals to 10 by 10, that is equals to 1 meter per second square. These are the references that we are using for creation of this video. Thank you.